That was an interesting tank slapper. Morning viewers, early morning ride out today, still dark out, but yeah, I've been wanting to go back to the Cedarburg for some time now. So a group of us meeting up with a group now, a small group just outside of Cape Town, and then riding to Sirius and meeting up with a bigger group there. So yeah, let's see what this day has in store for us. I'm really looking forward to it. Yeah, let's get going. Okay, ready to rock and roll. Okay, met up with the second group at petrol station. All filled up, everyone's happy. Reset trip counter. From here is to hit the Katbakkies pass, go through there and then on to Tankwa Padstal. Probably end up stopping again not that far from here, and I'm going to be riding very slow. I don't feel like coming off today. I really don't spend enough time on dirt. Still feel quite uncomfortable riding the dirt. Guys in front are blasting away. The biggest problem is because I don't ride dirt often, that and I haven't really explored the limits of what I can do in terms of grip, so I'm struggling a little bit. It also feels a little bit sandy compared to the last time I rode this road. I don't know, maybe it's just different, maybe I'm just out of practice. I guess the trick here is to try and keep to the track where cars have driven. As soon as you get to these sandy bits or those rocks on the sides, it starts getting sketchy. Oh, I'm going a little bit fast. I don't want to slow down. So, as I was saying, these tracks sometimes just disappear and then all of a sudden you hit the side where the bike starts becoming alive underneath you, and I'm still not 100% comfortable when the bike does that, but what I do know is you don't want to tap off or brake. Putting weight on the front wheel is probably the worst thing you can do. So there's two ways of doing it. It's essentially try to keep power on the rear wheel or accelerate out of it. The landscape also doesn't make it any easier, because you kind of just want to look around you all the time as well, and next minute you need to some sketchy sandy bits or rocky gravel, whatever you call this. That's sand. Okay, I'm through. Okay. Maybe try standing up a little bit. So this portion of Katbakkies is tarred, and I think the reason it's tarred is due to the incline. This is some steep stuff. So the nice thing that I enjoy about these group rides that we do is everyone kind of follows their own pace, and there's certain stops that people stop to regroup. So, I mean, anyone can really ride it. From the experienced guys, which are way up there, I'm kind of in the middle of the pack with a few guys behind me. And then we just follow the road, essentially, and, you know, people would end up catching up. Like, yeah. Julle manne klaar moeg. Julle klaar moeg. Okay, back on the road again. So lucky this group, they like stopping quite a lot, so it's quite nice to have brakes often. It gives my camera batteries the time to charge as well. But yeah, like I said before, we're stopping, like, the guys stop quite often and you know, make sure everyone is safe and everyone's grouped and have a chat and whatever. So it's quite pleasant. Back onto the dirt. We still have quite a journey ahead of us. Guys braver than I am. I must say, I'm quite happy not being on having a tank bag this time. Feels a little bit easier without being restricted with movement like I was previous rides. That was an interesting tank slapper. That's just what I mean with riding these bikes on these kind of surfaces. Is what happened back there was I was supposed to be able to not, I wouldn't say panic, but I should, you know, just being able to throttle through it. So when you start going through the runts, and you get slapped from side to side, it gets scary. I definitely need to put in some time, take you with a smaller bike, and maybe go ride some proper sand. Start getting used to that movement of the bike. Jeez, those guys are paid with quite some distance. You can actually see the dust in that far in the distance. I wonder if it's actually them. Back of the tar. Definitely not a corner you want to misjudge. This downhill looks painful. Oh, this is the portion of the L355. So if I continue straight onto this road, I'll end up in Calfinia, which is still quite a distance. But at about 2 kilometers, we've got the Padstal, the Tankwa Padstal, a very cool little rustic place in the middle of nowhere. It's got quite a lot of weird attractions. I think if everyone's ever wants to go out somewhere, somewhere quite remote and actually going to have some bite to eat, this is definitely a place to consider. Although it's in the middle of nowhere with no cell reception or anything like that, I know that they do have Wi-Fi, so you can at least check in with people. Quite cool. I mean, where else in South Africa would you see a UFO? Oh, that's seriously cool. Oh man. Someone even came with a helicopter, a little Robertson 44. That's very cool. Car nosedived. Romeo, Juliet, Charlie. Go. All right.
When you run out of luck, need to get unstuck, so golf. When you're up against the wall and you cannot fall, so golf, golf.